Time to play with some clay.
I've got work to do on his body. So let's get started. Now, like I said, he's a beginning warrior. He's not attained war honors or war prizes. This is really kind of like his first raid he's going on. And so he's basically got a few things that he's accumulated over the years. At least that's a story I'm putting together. Problem with having your GoPro right in front of you is your stupid visor keeps bumping the camera, which makes it sit there and wobble. I gotta figure out what texture I'm gonna put on this robe. Do now is work on the rifle.
because weapons were so valuable, the traded weapons, the even an old flintlock like he's using, it would be so valuable that he would have a sheath of leather
over it
to protect it. And I'm going to attempt to sculpt that on here. I've got these photos I took of an authentic gun that was used by Native Americans to fight with, and if you can see, it was a flintlock with a cut-off barrel. And the reason they'd cut the barrel off is because if they were riding on horseback, a long barrel would, it would get in the way. You can see the view. That's about the scale right there. This picture of that rifle. Just putting fringe on the opening to the sheath. Apologize for the inability to show you what I'm doing back here, but that's just part of the problems with having just a couple of cameras and hard to reach views. And I just do the best I can. finish this side of the blanket first so I can put the fringe on the bottom part of the scabbard. Got to get the texture worked out before I can put the fringe on. Taking the mane off the horse, never really was satisfied with that. I'm going to change the angle of the head and the neck a little bit, but I'll need to heat up my knife to do that with. And let's see, where's my lighter? The reason I heat up the knife is because it softens the clay underneath the hot blade. Something else, the clay is stiffened a lot. Some of the oils in the clay have evaporated from the clay, which makes it just a little bit harder. It's been almost 2 years, maybe more, that I've sculpted this horse. And I can feel the stiffness. It just takes a matter of starting to work on it again, and it'll work fine. But anyway, I just have a vision in my head what I want that horse to be doing. Got to be mindful of the armature I got underneath it too. By the way, this horse is the one that I created on the instructional DVD set, the two DVD set that I put together called Creating a Horse from Scratch. You might check that out on the link that I have in my video description below this video. It just goes to show you, once you create the horse, you can change it and reposition it and do whatever you want to after it's been sculpted. It's getting the basic horse that really counts. Gonna have to put some wrinkles in his neck because it's putting a stress on the skin, his movement. But I'll have to work that out later. I think what I'm gonna do is call it quits for tonight. And come back tomorrow and see how I feel about this repositioned horse's head. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.